Welcome or welcome back to my channel, guys. Welcome back to my marathon. Oh my god, I'm so excited to be here. I've missed Tibatu so much. I've missed you guys. I feel like it's been so long since I filmed for marathon. I took like 4 days off from filming because I was filming so much like last week, and it was just a lot. But welcome back to my marathon. So we're on episode 13. And we are finally here at the Dream Eternity full album, mini album. I think this is the full mini album listening party. Woohoo! I'm so excited. I know all of these songs are gonna be amazing. I hear so many good things about this album. Now, I've already listened to Can't You See Me. If you haven't seen that was in season one of my TXT series, so go watch that if you haven't. That'll be linked in the eye and in the description box. And then I already reacted to Puma and Eternally. Now, like I said in my Eternally music video reaction, obviously the full song wasn't playing, so I'm gonna go ahead and revisit the full song here at the end of the video, because if we're going in like order of the album, we have Drama, Fairy of Shampoo, Maze in the Mirror, and then we're gonna revisit Eternally. Now, I did hear a little bit of Eternally because I reacted to the music video, like I just said in the last episode. So I'm so scared. I'm so excited. I feel like this song is going to take me on a roller coaster. So I don't know how to feel, but Mo, welcome back. I'm excited to be here. We're really just going to hop right in. We have Drama first, which I hear a lot of good things about. The song I'm really, really excited for is Fairy of Shampoo. I hear so many good things about that song, and I truly can't wait to like dive into it. That's the song we're getting to next. Anyways, I'm going to shut up and I'm going to screen record. So like I said, we have Drama. I have my iPad sitting on this little iPad stand. And that's paint, by the way. This is my cousin painted all over it. I don't know why. But if I'm looking down, that's what I'm looking at. So Drama, 1, 2, 3. Eternity. Oh my god. Oh my god. Wait. Is this gonna be like a ballad? Is that Bumpy? This sounds like a oh, I love claps. Ooh, the Ooh. Ooh, oh my god. I love this. You know what's crazy? Literally when it started, I was like, this song should be in like a K-drama, like for real. It's sweet. This is so like upbeat and happy. I love this. Ooh. Oh, the extra one that Yeonjun's talking about. Okay, you know in Zerba 1 how they like only, but they spelled only with a 1? That's what I've just picked up on. Jesus, can't speak. Breathe. They sound so good. The runs that are going on. The eyes, my favorite part. My delusion. Oh my god, please me. What? I love the song. It's so happy. It's so cute. It's very like a. This is such a summer song. Oh, the claps. Is that Hyuning? The fucking run falsetto. Ooh, the build-up. Yeonjun. The fucking falsetto going on. Is that Subin? Wait, hold on. The layering of the falsetto high fucking tone and the low voice. That sounds like it would also kind of. Oh my god! It kind of sounded like Carrie too. The background vocals, do you guys hear that? This is so good. Just the feeling of the song is very like happy. Like, oh my god. This is a song where you like drive down the coast and go down your road and just blast it. This is so good. the way they ended it. That was so good. Whoa, 2x2. That was good. Oh my god, wait, guys, drama. I can see why a lot of people like this song, but I feel like at the same time, I don't see, wait, where my chapstick go? My lips is dry. I feel like I heard so much about the song, but I also feel like I haven't at the same time. Like, I don't know, I feel like it's a very, like, I hear songs like this upbeat and happy all the time, so I feel like it's not that surprising that TXT have one. Obviously, you see the title of the song, but when it first started, I immediately thought, I was like, this song should be in a drama. Like, you know how dramas, like, K-dramas have, like, montages and stuff of, like, characters and the actors and the actresses? Like, this should, that should be, like, a drama OST. Like, that's so good. It, like, suits the vibe of K-dramas. Like, guys, that was drama. That was so good. I really do like that song. But I feel like so far, my favorite out of this album probably would be Puma or the title track. So far, obviously, we haven't listened to all the songs yet, but okay, that was drama. Now we're gonna do Fairy of Shampoo. I'm so excited for this song, guys. I hear so many good things about it, and I'm excited. We're just gonna hop right into Fairy of Shampoo because I have waited too long to listen to the song. Okay, Fairy of Shampoo, 1, 2, 3. Oh, is this gonna be like magical? Is it gonna be like, oh, okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Oh, this is giving me Eternally, Magic Island, Nap of a Star, like that, ooh, like the magical feel. I don't even know how to describe it besides like magical, like mystical. Kinda sounds like Carrie. I'm like frozen. Oh wait! Oh my god! Why does this give me like the jazz classical music kind of vibe? The lyrics. In my Fairy of Shampoo from this one on, I Will Love You. I like this. The trumpet. Yeah, that's why I'm getting like classical jazz kind, because the instruments are being used. I like it. Like, I unexpectedly like it, even though I don't listen to jazz or classical music. Or anything that has a trumpet, really. But it sounds good. Yeonjun always gotta throw a rap in somewhere. Like, I think their voices, their falsettos, the fact that they all can do falsetto, they can all sing in falsetto, amazes the fuck out of me. Like, they really are a eight. They're all aces. Like, these lyrics, though. The flow of it is so soothing for the song. It's so pretty. He sounds so good on this song. Like, he sounds like an angel. Is that Terry for real? This part. Is this pre-chorus? The falsetto. The fact that I don't feel lonely when I see, even if I'm with my sad heart, it just appears far away. Sorry, I can't speak. I feel that. Oh my god. TXT have really done every genre of music, haven't they? Jesus. Slow down. Oh my god. Who is that? Is this Sugun really? It kind of sounds like Sugun. But goddamn the falsetto. so weird. In a good way. Like, I love, this is such like a, you listen to this when you're trying to relax at the end of the week. Like, it's one of those songs for me. I would have never expected TXT to do a song like that. I thought Fairy of Shampoo was gonna be like all bright and bubbly like Blue Hour. Even though it's not off of the same album, so I don't know why I would expect that. But like, I feel like because of how much it was praised, I feel like my brain just went to that. It's weird because like after listening to that, I feel so relaxed and at ease. Like, it's definitely a comfort song. And like, oh my god, like I could fall asleep to that. Like, not saying that like it's boring, but like it's so comforting. And it has that groove to it that's just like relaxing. Dang, I love that song. Holy shit. Cups for 2x2. Honestly, have they done every genre? That was good. I feel like I'm like speechless because I didn't expect that. So next we have Maze in the Mirror. I'm scared. I feel like it's gonna be one of those songs that like see the title and it's like, I did not expect this. Like, for me, that's how I felt with Can We Just Leave the Monster Alive. Like, I thought that shit was gonna be like Puma, where it's like, you know what I mean? But it's not. So I feel like it's gonna be one of those deceiving songs. But we're just gonna hop right into it because I wanna listen to this. So we have Maze in the Mirror. 1, 2, 3. Skip ads. Oh my god. Yeonjun. I'm gonna run, but in the mirror in the maze. This is acoustic, bitch. This is acoustic. They sound. They sound so unreal. They sound so good. Oh my. This simple guitar. Oh my god. This is my favorite part of the song. Jeonjun. Are they being asked to be pushed in the mirror or pulled out? They all sound so good like this. But the guitar sounds good. The way Yeonjun sounds, punch me in the throat. Oh. The fact that he's talking about Peter Pan, because you know he's like, Peter Pan's like there's theories about him not even being like he's kind of like dead and like Neverland's like heaven or something. That's kind of wow. Oh my god. The falsettos in the song are insane. Ooh, more. Oh, harmonies in the background. Harry, I know that scene. The song feels so like. This part with the drums. What are they called? Cymbals? Oh my god. This, what? Dude, what? This is a constant, like, what the fuck, TXT? I thought this was, See, this is what I'm saying. This is definitely not what I thought it was gonna be. I thought, oh my, I don't even know what I thought anymore. Like, that was so good. The amount of like slower songs they have on this album, and like the fact that they include so many of them on each of their albums is insane. They already have like Fairy of Shampoo is slower. I almost said Eternally is slow, but I feel like that hoe, which we're gonna listen to in a second, is gonna fucking punch me in the throat too, and just like go back and forth. And then, oh my god, Puma's kind of fast. Drama's a little bit slower too. It's not like too fast paced. So that's why I'm sitting here like, oh, what the fuck? Holy shit. Damn. Okay. Well, guys, another one bites the dust. This whole album is sick. Like, honestly, this whole album is a no skip. Okay, so that is Maze in the Mirror. Next, we have Eternally. I feel like I'm just gonna, wow. Okay, I'm just gonna start. I know what some of the song sounds like, and I'm scared that this is gonna take me through an emotional ring. Okay, Eternally. 1, 2, 3. Oh, hell. Yeah, this is the part that we heard in the music video. It sounded so melodical and pretty. Oh. Talking about the nightmare. Like, this is so pretty. It sounds so magical, mystical. What are the Yeonjun? No, stop. Why the fuck? Like, what the fuck? Why did it? So that was Eternally. That was Yeonjun? Why did it just switch up like that? Bitch, what happened to the fucking talking about nightmares? And now you're what the fuck? That part of the song is so good. I love those lyrics. Guys, what the fuck is this song? You wanna end up. Why is it going back and forth? Is this almost over? I'm tired of this slander. I want this to be over. I'm tired of tears. What the fuck? Why? You let it go, beautiful, crying. So what the fuck? What is this? Guys, the gunshots, I'm sorry, how am I supposed to digest this? How am I supposed to digest something that just shot at me and made me cry? What the fuck? I'm genuinely so confused. You know what's crazy though? I feel like because it switches back and forth a lot of people might not like this song. But personally, I like it. I really, this might be when like my top five of the whole album. I have, there's a lot to grasp, to grab onto. What the fuck? They're gonna go from Don't Go Breaking My Heart to talking about like, I feel like I can't even speak about Eternally anymore, because what the fuck am I supposed to say? I feel like I have to digest it, listen to it again, and really process the fact that they really went back and forth and tried to play with my emotions like that. Oh, that was my reaction to the Eternally album. Eternally, I said Eternally album in a video before. I meant to say Eternity album. I get the words confused because they both start with the E. But Moa, that was my reaction. That was honestly a very good album. This album is good. My favorite tracks, Puma, Maze in the Mirror, Can't You See Me, obviously, and then Eternally. They're my top four of this album. I like the other songs, obviously, and no duh, because this whole album is sick. But those are like my favorites. I feel like I listen to them more than the others. But this was insane. Definitely a roller coaster of emotions. They went from ballad, because like in order, it goes from Drama to Can't You See Me to Fairy of Shampoo to Maze in the Mirror to Puma to Eternally. So like, I feel like the transition from Puma to Eternally is kind of like a whoa, because it's like flashing back and forth between the two. But this album was really good. I liked it. I will see you guys in the next episode, which is Drama music video. I think I'm getting to Everlasting Shine too. But I'll see you guys soon. This album was amazing. But I'll see you guys for more Moa Thon, for more TXT soon. Bye!